season. Reverend Paul Burstrom from the Covenant Children's Home in Princeton will be doing the invocation right now. Don Allen from the chamber, looking very nervous, and Mayor Welby will also be involved in the... Let me get back behind these gentlemen here. Mayor Welby from right here in Princeton doing the 1992 ribbon cutting ceremony. Mayor?
It's a pleasure to be here tonight, and I welcome everybody here, and let's have a big season, and we'll get this thing on the road here, outside of the duck.
Okay. They want the duck in the picture.
Duck,
duck what? Why has that duck been shaved on the rear there?
Oh,
it's a shaved duck.
Steve, I kissed this duck in front of the grandstand the other day. Isn't that enough? You realize all these people are my friends? Huh? Let's leave it up to them whether I kiss the duck behind. Think I ought to kiss it? We're gonna go ahead.
Okay, here we go. All right, we're gonna cut the ribbon and Mayor Welby. Yay! 1990, all right. We're about ready to, for Doc.
What happened to the duck? Oh, that's enough ducking around for this year, Steve. Maybe next year, okay?
What kind of a shenanigans happened with that deal? Where did it go?
Let's go racing. On behalf of the Princeton Chamber of Commerce, let's race. They're saying no. We gotta do it. Well, we gotta do it.
I'm sorry, Don. I was just kidding you a while ago. Oh. Oh, that's terrible. I'll tell you one thing right now. You shouldn't have any problems doing that because I've been talking to your wife. She tells me that she's been kissing the horses we're in for many years.
Here, Steve.
What? Okay. What do you think, guys? All right, ladies and gentlemen, listen, well, this isn't over yet. Let's give Don a hand, the mayor and Reverend Bergstrom and all the folks that are very supportive of this racetrack, and that's what it takes to make one of these racetracks work here in the Midwest right now. I'm not quite sure what division this guy's in. Not quite sure what division this guy's in or what's going on. It looks like a... Kind of looks like a modified that got caught between two semis. What's going on here? What's the deal here, partner? You gotta do what? Practice is over. What are you gonna practice for? What girl? That blonde? You forgot? I don't know, Bumper. It seems like we're about ready to get the regular racing program on. What are you going to practice for? Practice for what? We got a trophy girl here or something. I don't know what's going on. Now he thinks that now you're supposed to race before you pose with a trophy girl. You're supposed to run around the track. You're supposed to race first, Bumper. You can't pose in winner's circle with a trophy girl. You have to do practice lab. You have to win her. You have to win a race first. No, you better take the car with you. The car. The car, Bumper. He spent too many days in the sun down there at Daytona Beach. Too many days in the sun. Oh, he's got his helmet and his goggles. Got it on sale? Where at? Oh, he's got a left. Turn left. No notes. You can't have a helmet with notes. Turn left. Oh, I see. Now, where'd you get the trophy girl? She followed you? She looks like one of those Daytona Beach ladies. Yeah, your hair looks really racing shoes that I'm concerned about. Dale Earnhardt? It looks like the kind of shoes that Dale's been wearing lately. Well, Bumper, what are you going to do now? You're supposed to run around the track now. Go left when you get down there at that big curve.
Oh, how are you doing?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I guess Bumper is going to take a few hot laps here this evening as he gets himself in his Dale Earnhardt shoes into his modified. He's firing it up. Bumper, wait a minute. Wait, Bumper. My God, he forgot his steering wheel. My God, he forgot it. He was headed towards the wall. That's reserved for the Carter family. What's he doing now? Ladies and gentlemen, let's give Bumper a big hand out of Daytona Beach, Florida. He'll be here throughout the course of the evening entertaining you folks. Bumper from Daytona Beach, Florida. Entertaining race fans throughout the country, the Busch Grand National Races, the Winston Cup Races. He's scheduled to entertain the Dale, or the Richard Petty Celebration down in North Carolina in July. Bumper the Clown out of Daytona Beach, Florida. I think he's going to take that thing for a couple of spins, I believe. Snap-on tool, car number 71. Here we go, E race number 2 on the pole, the car number 11. The driver, Alex Sterling, Don Schultz for the Midwest Tires, Dave Corner Tap, the BJ Jones, the water conditioning, and interceptor material. On the outside is car number 29, that's Rick Healy on Rock Falls, Indiana Automotive, car number 29. Inside, row number 2, number 17A out of Princeton, Brad Anderson. The day we open with the Princeton Farm, the Diamondback Race Stars on the Race 17A. Jerry Perry, Bill Radiator, car 59. Car number 66, Bill Parks, out of Walnut, TWAP Services. That's your lineup, big race number 2. 17A having a problem getting fired up down there in the 17A. Once again, the red car, number 11, that car is Kenny Anderson out of Preston. In the black 11 car, is Don Phillips or Sterling. I switched those two drivers, calling the first order of racing action right now into heat race number 2 in this bomber division. Doug Hack, the man in charge, down on the front straightaway. Your flagman for the...
Now. Woo! The smoke is rolling out of the city. 29 and 4 to 1.
Jay Electric, the driver, Randy Summer. Randy Summer, the outside, that's the R3, another one of the Ransom brothers. In the R3, that's John Ransom. He's in the Henry Napa, Ted Lamico. The Newton Memorial Home, and Henry, too. R3, in the front row, inside the car number 11, and the WDLC radio, the Terry's Repair, Minnesota, Gilhorn Trucking. Driving the car number 28 out of New Bedford is Bill Jensen. Bill Jensen in the car number 28. Inside, row number 3, the car number 67, Tom Carter. Tom Carter in the hitching post. Bearing distributor, car number 67 to the outside. Car number 57, Don Meekum Jr. in the car number 57 in the farmer's table, the farmer's garage. 17. On the outside, number 22. That's Bobby Mitchell out of Cherry, Illinois, and the Mayor Oil. Super CFL Tequila Eddie. Car number 22. And the last car, the car number 11. Want to welcome Wally Stargell out of Butte, and a
Yeah. Ohio Quorum, Carl 21, Carl Hayes, head of the Brisbane. The 92 opener here for the modified.
All right, here we are, the D-Race number two. On the pole or off the side.
Car number 50, I'll tell ya. Frank Squire and Johanna Trumper. Sonny. Copy out of Fortville, Indiana, and a major ass shot. Car number 50 to the outside.
Well, they got a yellow. Keep the job. Public Discount Auto Parts. Our good friends from Paper Motors, Browning Ford, Schumer Ford Sales, Strictly Gandria Center, Benelli's Restaurant.
Thank you.
Texas, Gilmarth, out of Walnut, and the Parabush, trucking the PWAG services inside, an extra 63B is Bob Mueller out of Ohio. To the outside, car number 5, Jamie Balancevan. In the Sissel service, the Circle W welding, the complete landscaping. Car number 5 inside, the next row, car number 74. Car number 74 driven by Chad Vander Beach out of Lads and the W number for the Hickey Boat, the Valley and Silk, Energy Services. To the outside, car number 57. That's Don and Jacob Jr. Guitars, car number 9 to the outside, car number 29 is Rick Seeley in the BMN Automotive 29, the next row, car number 28. That's Bill Jensen out of New Bedford. On the outside, car number 22, David Shepard. He's in an Amy vending home painting, Pasty Freeze and Benelli's Russa. The next row, 17A, Brad Anderson, W. Immelman, Turpin Farm, Diamondback Racing Tire. Flat tire, I'm not sure. Well, race night. And Reamer Automotive. Out of Mandoto, we get folks down here helping us out with the record service each and every race night. First, I want to thank them for that. Once again, I thank you to R&S Oval Track Supply for running up with the season of the first stuff. I want to thank you, gentlemen, for being here helping out with Mark. These race cars. I want to acknowledge our rescue squad for flying up, and two for being here with the big race night. WGLC Radio, tonight's race sponsor, that's 100.1 FM from Minnesota. Be tonight's racing sponsor. Well, it looks like we're going back to racing green here as they roll down the back chute.
We're eliminating cars. I know this is a
bomber
semi, but, you know, I thought they're close to finish the race
now. Yeah. It's coming up now, and Davis. season in this bomber division here was a big, big deal. The bombers starting off tonight. Young man from right here in Princeton riding the flowers by Julia, the half marathon. Raceway, the Nicholson barn, Nicholson coming and eating. Car number 45, Randy Luca. Randy Luca, there he is, let him hear it. Randy Luca picking him off, and boy, picking him up and laying him down, taking a feature win here in that car number 44, starting off at 1992. GLC Radio, and they're all getting in there as Kathy Casterson taking the winning photo. Randy Lucas, your winner in a bomber feature here tonight. Receiving the trophy from WGLC Radio representative Cindy Stamberger. Diamondback race car, Rick Anderson. And the last car, the car number 11, the driver from Judah, Wally Sargell, in the Wolf's Rod, Steve Rainier, Jeffy Arado, Salvage, and Hydrotest Lubricant. All right, let's lay them on, race fans. Lay them on, your favorite car driver. That's three stars, picture time. Everybody, wave your hands, wave your hands. Here it goes. Keep on, supercar. Now, oh, boy, just a little sideways. He brings it back and hangs on. Bruce Brandt I get a good showing of the car number 9, first time out here. So I see the young man right here out of Mendota, Tim Kenny. And a Wally Sturgill in the car number 11. And here they come now, rolling out of three.
Thank you.
is each and every night the racing action here at the Bureau County Speedway. Phil Jensen, Judy Sharp, a good job of filming the racing action here each race night. Also filming at the Bureau, at the Bureau Speedway, Knox County Speedway, East Moline Raceway.
Down in the right places here. Got it up one more time into three now. Brent Squire wins the
WGLC Radio, Cindy Stamberger, and the folks from WGLC going out to present the winner there with his beautiful trophy, and there's bumper. No, bumper. It goes the other way. The other way, bumper. The other way, bumper. Thank you for coming out.